Welcome back to Let's Play a Tear of Vermillion Blind. We are now leaving the Benequia Monastery, killing monstres. I was supposed to return Archim here on the right back to her house with her grandfather. We'll see if that really comes along as planned. If she stays with us, I'll get her better weapons and armor. I think that's the first monster she's ever killed. Like, got the killing blow. We just feel like killing you. He put it to sleep. Yeah, random effect. Really, I want Archim to stay with us longer than that. Oh, who's this? Blue Bandana Man? Says, hey, you. Are you going to New Borun? Yeah, says Avon. Right. The man took out a small bottle of shining silver. The hell's all this about? What? What was that? Says Avon. It's a kind of spell. That town is being punished. You should pass by it quickly. What? Who was that? Douglas says, that man is an experienced fighter. He didn't have one unguarded moment. Archim says, but his eyes looked a little sad. Yo! You're back at. What kind of spell? You know, it's the second spell that's been cast on us. And I can't tell any difference. He's still got 53 magic points and 100 hit points. Well, max. Very strange. Blue Bandana Man. Okay, then. If you insist. Ouch. So, a spell or something put on New Borun? What's all that about? I mean, we have to pass through there anyway to get back to the woods. What's this? Says Avon. It's like a fog. Miles says, it smells like a rotten egg. That's not good, says Douglas. Don't breathe in too deep. Are you feeling sick, Archim? Says Avon. No, I'm okay. This silver liquid that the man splashed onto our clothes is purifying the air around us. I think it's sacred water.
Oh.
Mile says, I remember the guy said this town was being punished. What did he mean by being punished? And for what? Is it that great... What's his name again? Avarice? The great Oracle Avarice? I mean, with a name like that... Well, the barrel of waterless is still there. Hello? Well, he seems normal. Oh, is she sick? Hunter Rob. What is going on? What's this fog? Don't talk to me. I have a headache and have no energy left to respond. Wow. Hey, don't you feel sick? I am so dizzy. The lady's not here. Oh, she's up here. Air is better here than downstairs, but we can't stay here forever. That's pretty smart. Tony says, ugh, I'm nauseous. What did I do to deserve this? Grats. What's wrong with me? I have a sore throat. They don't notice the smoke and fog around here? Should I close the store? I feel nauseous. What's wrong with me? I can't breathe. I knew it. It was true. The prophecy came true. Is he right? Is the fog of what the prophecy said would happen? I didn't have eaten unusual today. What? I can't even read that correctly. I didn't have eaten a unusual today. But I feel nauseous. I think you're about to have a stroke as well. I can't work like this. No way! Get a grip on yourself, will you? That girl was walking around here. She's... not out here anymore. Can't say I'm surprised. Douglas, you're back. Hilt, why is your store still open? You should evacuate to the basement. People need weapons in a time of crisis like this. They may come to my store for help. I'm more concerned about my sisters. I survived rigorous training. I won't collapse because of bad air. Please go to the front of the counter. I don't want to buy anything right now. Oh, there's both of them. Oh, there's the one who usually wanders around outside. In bed. My brother came back with Chitta. He had a panicked face. My cough doesn't stop. Douglas says, "We'll go and see what's causing this. Can you take care of her for a while?" I started to have a pounding headache, too. I wonder if my brother is okay. Uncle Douglas, I have a sore throat. Chitta, hang in there for a while. I'll let you breathe in fresh air soon. If we try to leave, does he stop us? Let's search the town a little more, says Mile. Right, says Even. I think the only place I haven't looked is the... Well, there's the mayor. And the, guy for the Avenger Guild here. Hi, Even. Are you alright, Mayor? Suddenly the air is filled with a veil of fog. I felt suffocated and became dizzy. Do not worry about me. Please go and take a look at how other people are doing in town. Mayor. Okay, we'll do that. Thank you. He's the only guy we haven't talked to, right? Just checking. Yeah. I'm sorry. I have this terrible headache and I can't work. Please come back some other time. Do you have anything else? It's strange, says Douglas. Douglas, are you conscious? Even says, why are you asking Douglas if he's conscious? He obviously is. I can't feel any wind, says Douglas. Usually cool breezes blow from the north at this time of the day. Archim says, the breeze is from Tree Spirit Forest. The soft breeze is carrying their soothing smell. I agree. Something is wrong. Miles says, it may have something to do with this fog. Who's that? Oh, Shannon. What a foul smell. What's going on? Did she come to be with our prince? I'm in danger. Any Heroine goes through an ordeal or two. Oh, where is my Mile now? Mile! Huh? Mile! Shannon? Oh, is it fate that brought you here? I knew we were bound to be together. How come you're here? I followed you, of course. When you're in trouble, I come to rescue you. When I'm in trouble, you come to rescue me. What's wrong? Says Mile. My head is spinning. Ah, Mile! Hey, Shannon! Who is she? Says Douglas. Even says, well, it's a long story. A long story, huh? I can't believe Shannon followed you, Mile, says Even. Douglas says, don't make too many girls cry, lady killer. You think this is funny? The waitress will look after Shannon for the time being. Archim says, it seems Shannon is a girl with a pure heart. She must love you so much. I think you two make a wonderful couple. Not you too, Archim. Please don't tease me. I thought she was your girlfriend. No way is she my girlfriend. I can't believe she followed me here. How can I convince her to go back? Avon says, let's think about Shannon later. We must get rid of the fog first. If it stays, people in town will be in serious trouble. I was thinking, says Archim. Well, that was your first mistake, Archim. This may be the disaster my grandfather was talking about. Douglas says, oh, he said some kind of disaster would befall if Meefus became extinct. Are you saying it's happening already? Miles says, let's talk to Archim's grandfather and find out the details. Avon says, we must take Archim home anyway. Let's hurry to Tree Spirit Forest. Avon, says Archim. Yeah? What is it? No, nothing. What were you gonna say? Out with it. Now I'm wondering. Mile. My mile. Walking the mile, walking the green mile. I'll look after Shannon, so don't worry about her. Thank you, says Mile. don't think she's gonna say anything new. 60 roses a night. Oops, well, let's try anyway. Yeah. They say different things now? It's all saying the same things. For better or worse. Checking. We have no time going back to Borun. Back to the forest. Boom. Oh, nice! It took out two of those things. Well, those things are strong, too. That's pretty cool if you have a sword that can emit sonic waves. Oh. That's not the way. Not the way, not the way. One-shotted. Archim, level 11. Now remember, it's northwest. Fine. Nice! I like it's doing that every time. What's wrong, Archim? Says Mile. It's strange. What is? Asks Avon. I can't feel them. Something must have happened. They really drove these things into extinction already? Have they taken all the Meefas? Says Douglas. But there are no signs of struggle. Mile says it may have something to do with what happened to the town. Avon says, well, let's hurry to Archim's home. First we'll fight these monsters. Still have these lights floating around. Boom. I missed. You're doing all right. Can't go that way. Come back here, you. We'll thrash you good. It's not even worth it. Let's just have her do it. That one puts her to sleep. This is gonna be redundant. Music of forest give calmness. Another thing but went to sleep twice. That's why you see bubbles with sheep in them though. Thank you. Coup de grâce. So I'm heading... I forget which way I was heading. Up this way? Boom! Really barely need it. Now just in case. Some battle royal up ahead or something like that. Oh, you're back. What's wrong? Did Great Oracle say anything mean to you? Avon says, that's a part of it, but there's more serious trouble going on. Archim says, Grandpa, New Borun is in trouble. They told Karaba about what happened in New Borun. What a tragedy. I didn't expect this to happen this soon. Avon says, does it have anything to do with Meefa's disappearance? The poisonous swamp south of New Borun is spreading. The mist you saw must be the evil spirits coming from that swamp. Well, that came out of nowhere, but Douglas says, but why did the evil spirits come now? I can understand if there's been some damages, but I have never heard anything like that before. I see, Miles says. It's a wind, Douglas. A wind? A wind blowing into New Borun from the woods? A fragrance from Meefa's has an effect to purify poisons. What if a wind containing the fragrance was reaching to the poisonous swamp going through New Borun? Douglas says the evil spirits can disappear too. Just as Mr. Miles suspects. A fragrance from Meefa's revitalizes plants and causes wind to blow by rising temperature in the entire woods. Woods and Meefa's. This place is only livable thanks to both. Archim says, since the hunting started, they have started to be afraid of humans. They must be hiding somewhere. Avon says, if Meefa's wouldn't return forever, New Borun would turn into a town of dead. We don't have time to just sit around. We gotta find Meefa's as soon as possible. Do you have any idea where Meefa's could be? One place I could think of is... There is a wide cave called the Golda Cave, which is ahead of the mountain path after going toward northwest through the woods. I think it's northeast, isn't it? Weren't we by there? That's the only place around here they can hide. It's worth paying a visit, says Mile. Alright, let's go to that cave, says Avon. Avon, says Archim, I'm going to the Golda Cave alone. What? Because you are on a journey to find your sister. I don't want to bother you anymore. I'll persuade them and get them back to New Borun without fail. So please don't worry and keep on your journey. Listen, Archim, I do want to see Imel, and I will do anything to make that happen. But that doesn't mean that I should be a man who can leave alone someone in trouble. I think Imel would be disappointed if I was such a person. I want to be her brother whom she can be proud of. Avon, Whew. Douglas says, "You're quite a person, considering you're still a kid." Avon says, "A word, kid, is not necessary." Miles says, "Look, Archim, Avon is nosy by nature. He's not the kind of person who can walk out of a girl... out... on a girl who can use his help and keep on a journey. He could be annoying, but please forgive him." "Not annoyed at all. I'm the one who has to ask you." Avon says, "Well, that's what we're gonna do. Let's head to the cave." "Yes, thank you. Grandpa, I go now."
Please take good care. Going through this woods toward northeast, you will find a mountain path.
Yeah, I knew he meant northeast. It's down where we saw, the doctor. Dr. Bandle. Funny name.
Go straight on the path and you will get to the Golda Cave.
But I saw footprints of the big monsters around the mountain path recently. So, please be careful. Yeah, rest. That would be helpful. Alright, northeast, mountain path, go straight. Okay. Later, Gramps. Let's see how easily we can find this. You wanna fight?
Fight me!
So maybe we should have gotten her the chain mail and the big mace. Oh well. I don't wanna run all the way back there. We could, right? Yeah, I chose the wrong thing there. She can't reach that. Let us read this. East is Golda Cave. And here is Fight Monster. Boom. Oh no, wait, defense, never mind. I was waiting for the rock to come down. Oh, Golda Mountain Path, okay. Wind Mantis and Slay Scissors. Oh, damn. What's the finishing move on the Slay Scissors?
Yeah.
We're not that bad off yet. Oh, now we got two of those things. Flamethrower and Slay Scissors A. Sword Wind on Slay Scissors B. More XP this time. Okay, so there's a way up here. Oops. Thanks, kitty. Oh, one-shotted, nice. Guess those things aren't that tough. Alright, so let's see if the entrance... Nope. The chest is here. Stimulant. Yeah, we don't need any. If we find ourselves needing a stimulant, maybe we'll remember to come back to the chest. Or using a stimulant. These things might put us to sleep, I don't know. Missed. Gigantic claw. Ooh, getting close to that next level. We got to heal him. Guess I should have used a rarer on him. Well, there it is. The cave. Whatever it's called. Golden Cave? Golda Cave? That'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And, yeah, I hope we find these Meefas. Always seek adventure.